Hi, look at this. I created an automation that cycles through scenes in Home Assistant. Cool, isn't it? I will show you how to set this up in Home Assistant using a select helper, and as a bonus, I will show you how variables work in automations. Let's do this! Wouldn't it be great if you can cycle through scenes by simply clicking a button so that you and your partner can easily change the ambience of your room? This is actually not very difficult to do and super handy. You only need a smart button for this, like this Zigbee button, but any other button that you can connect to Home Assistant will do. The steps that we are going to take in this Home Assistant tutorial are as follows. Creating scenes for a room. Creating a select helper. Creating an automation to switch between scenes, and creating an advanced automation that switches between scenes and makes it also possible to create a scene selector on your dashboard. But before we move on, please like this video and subscribe to my channel. I need your support so that I can keep creating these videos for you. Let me first show you the scenes that I created in Home Assistant for my office. So we go to settings and then we go to automations and scenes. We go to scenes and let's go to the scenes that I created. Those are these three scenes: office scene cold, office scene cozy, and office scene green. Office scene cozy looks like this. I have some lights in here and some entities. The entities are my light groups. Office scene cold is it more blue. And office scene green is more green. So these are my office scenes, and you see that the names are office scene cozy, office scene cold, and office scene green. Did you know that scenes are not only limited to lights, but that you can also add other devices to scenes, and that you can create scenes on the fly to quickly restore all your devices to previous state? I published this video that explains exactly how scenes work. Check it out. Our scenes are now set up. The next thing that we are going to set up is a select helper. We can create a list of scenes in a select helper, and we will use this select helper in our automation. Let's set it up. For helpers, we are going to settings, devices and services. We click on helpers and we click on create helper. And we are going to create a drop-down helper, which is our select helper. We're going to give it a name, scene entities. And we are going to give it an icon, for instance, palette. And for the options, we are going to add the entity IDs for the three helpers that I just shown. So the scene cold, scene green, and scene cozy. So we're going to add an option. And the option is scene dot office scene cold. We are going to add another option, scene dot office scene green. And we are going to add another option, scene dot office scene cozy. So these are the three scenes that I just showed you in the scenes overview. We click on create, and now our scene selector is created. Now that we've set up the select helper, we can start building our automation. The automation will automatically cycle through our scenes and activate each scene. Let's set up the automation now. For automations, we go to settings, automations and scenes. We click create automation, we click start with an empty automation. We're going to add a trigger, and the trigger is our physical button. So in this case, it's a device, and the device is called, in my case, office 2-year switch. And we are going to trigger on the single action trigger, and I'm giving it a trigger ID. I always give triggers a trigger ID. So the trigger ID is button underscore press. Now we are going to actions. we are going to add an action, and the action is a call service, and the service is input select next. So we are going to select the next scene in our select helper. The target is called scene entities, and we leave cycle on, so that if we are on the last option in the drop-down box, it will go to the first one next. Now we're going to add another action, and that is the action that will actually activate the scene. So click add action. We are going to call a service again, and the service in this case is scene.turnOn. And now we cannot select a target because we need a little bit of YAML here. And for that, I'm going to click on the three dots, and I'm going to click on edit in YAML. And now I'm going to add the following code. Remove this, paste this. So what I'm doing here is targeting the entity ID, and the entity ID is taken from the drop-down box. So it takes the current state of the drop-down box, which is selected. And that is input underscore select dot scene underscore entities. Our drop-down box is called scene underscore entities. So let's save this. I'm going to give this automation a name. Click save. And now our automation is created. Okay, the automation is set up. Let's test this. Exciting! Yes, it works. Superb! We can now assign buttons in every room in our house to switch scenes. Isn't that awesome? Well, I think we can push this a little further and make sure that our select helper also works on a dashboard in Home Assistant. And in the progress, I will teach you how you can use variables in automations in Home Assistant. For this, we are going to create a slightly different select helper, and our automation will also look a bit different. If my videos help you, and if you want to stay up to date with my tutorials and not miss anything to increase your knowledge of Home Assistant and Smart Home, subscribe to my channel and tick the bell. It also helps if you post a comment. This way, more people get notified about these videos. I need your support so that I can keep creating these videos for you. Oh, and don't forget to hit the thumbs up for this video. This allows me to make more tutorials for you. By supporting me, you also support my work as a music therapist to help people with mental issues. Thank you. Because of the fact that we want to show our select helper in a dashboard, we are going to use friendly names in our select helper like so. We go to settings. We go to devices and services, we go to helpers, and we're going to create a new helper. And again, we're going to create the drop down helper. And this time we are going to call this the scene selector. We are giving it an icon palette. And now we are going to add some friendly names. So let's say cozy. Let's say work, and let's say green. Add. And now we created a new dropdown with only names in there. Let's click on create, and the new helper is saved. Our new select helper is now ready. Let's create a new automation that uses this select helper as input for cycling through the scenes. This new automation will work with our physical button and our dashboard scene selector. For our advanced automation, we go to settings, automations and scenes, create automation. We're going to start with an empty automation. I'm going to add a trigger. The trigger is device, and the device is again Office Tuya switch. The trigger is single action. I'm going to give it an ID. The trigger ID is button press. And I'm going to add another trigger, because that trigger is needed for our dashboard. And that trigger is a state trigger, so I'm choosing for state this time. And I'm going to say I want to trigger on the state of our input select scene selector, which we just created. Now we go to actions. We're going to add an action, and the first action is an if-then action. In the if, we are going to click on add condition. If triggered by button press, then we want to go to the next option in our drop-down list. So we are going to click on then. We are going to call a service, and the service is input select next. And we are going to say the entity is our scene selector. And now we are going to else. Let's close these two. Click add else. And what I want to do here is that I actually want to turn the scene on. So I'm going to click on add action. I'm going to call a service again. And the service is scene.turnOn. And now I have to select the target. The thing is that our drop-down list only consists of friendly names. So the name Cozy, Work and Green, and not of entity IDs. So here is where we are going to use variables to connect the friendly names to our entity IDs. For that, we go to the three dots right on the top. We click on Edit in YAML, and I'm going to add the variables somewhere here. I'm going to add the following code, variables. Then I'm going to declare the variable. The variable is called scene mapper in my case, colon. And now I'm going to fill the scene mapper with the three options that we have. And the first option is cozy, colon. And the entity ID of cozy is scene.office underscore scene underscore cozy. We do the same for the other two. So we have work, and the entity ID is scene.office scene called. And we had green, and the entity ID is scene.office scene green. So now we declared a scene mapper which contains a list of three values. But I will do that in the visual editor because that might be more clear to see. So I'm going to the three dots again, click on edit in visual editor. We open the actions again, scroll down to else, click scene.activate. And now I'm going to click on the three dots over here. I'm clicking on edit in YAML again, and I'm going to change the code data here by this code. And what this code is doing, it is again targeting an entity ID, but now it's using our variable, which is scene mapper, and it's picking the index of our scene mapper, so either cozy, work or green, because the trigger to state is, if we look here, is when scene selector changes. So the scene selector is our state trigger, which is our drop-down list. That returns either cozy, work or green. And so this will contain the value cozy, work or green. But because of the fact that we have the scene mapper, it will translate that to the corresponding entity ID. So to scene.office underscore scene underscore cozy, or scene.office underscore scene underscore cold, or scene.office underscore scene underscore green. And that is how variables work. So let's save this, give it a name. Click save. and our new automation is saved. One thing which is really important to make this work is that we have to change the mode of this automation. So we are going to the three dots over here, we click on change mode, and we're going to change it from single to queued. Now we're going to click on change mode and save it again. And now it will work. This is really important because if you leave it on single, it will not work because it needs the actions in the if and the else after each other immediately if you click on the button. Our new automation is now ready. Let's make sure that we disable our old automation so that it won't interfere with our new automation. Let's disable it. We go to settings. We go to automations and scenes. I'm going to search for our old automation, which is scene cycle based on entity ID. And I'm going to disable this automation. So now that one is disabled. Okay, let's test if our new automation works with our physical button. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. Yes, it works. That's great. Now, let's see if it also works on a dashboard. Let's create that. In my case, I'm going to tutorials. I'm going to click on the three dots, edit dashboard. I'm going to add another view. Let's call this scenes. We make this really simple. Save it. I'm going to add a card. Let's do the entities card. Remove these three. And we're going to add the entity, which is our drop down. Input. Select. Scene selector. Save this. And now I can switch. Let's click done. I can switch scenes here. And it will switch automatically to the correct color too, because of our automation that we just created. We've created the dashboard and it works. So we managed to create one automation that triggers based on a physical button and that also works together with our dashboard. And you learned how variables work in the process. If you don't want to type the code from the screen, you can download the code that I've created for this video via the Ko-fi link in the description below. With this, you sponsor me and make it possible for me to keep creating these videos for you. I hope that I managed to explain how you can create your own automations using variables to cycle through scenes in Home Assistant. This is just one example of how you can use select helpers in Home Assistant. I bet you can think of much more use cases. Please let me know in the comments what your use cases are. Oh, and a big shout out to the FAS for helping me to get my head around variables in Home Assistant. I want to thank everyone who has supported me in making these videos and tutorials so far. I could never have done this without you. Thank you. You can support me through Patreon, Ko-fi, or by joining my channel. If you also want to support me, look in the description of this video for the links. With that, you make it possible that I can continue to make these videos for you. And don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and hit the notification bell. I will see you soon. Bye bye.